Today we're going to head down range with Frank Proctore of The Way of the Gun, and he's going to cover with us multiple target transition and an exercise he calls the Eye of the Tiger.
Hey y'all, Frank Proctore with Way of the Gun Performance Shooting. Out at the range today, going to cover a little exercise on eye speed. I call this one Eye of the Tiger. Before we get into the exercise, first I need to explain my methodology on exercises. I call them exercises, not drills, and it's not just in a name. A lot of times when we go in the range and just shoot drills, we're not looking to get anything out of it. All right? It may be the 10th, 15th time that we do that drill that we finally hit something right. In the world of physical fitness, we do exercises with a progression towards an ultimate goal. So that's the methodology and mindset I have towards these exercises. Okay. So the Eye of the Tiger exercise, here's how it's going to go down, and then we'll talk through all the things that we can get out of it as a performance shooter, whether that's tactical, defensive, or competitive, or just better than your buddy. All right, so the way we're going to start this thing off, we're going to shoot one shot per target in numerical order. Okay, these index cards are a visual reference. We're going to shoot these 5 yards away, and what that's going to give us to scale is these index cards are about half the size of an IPSC A-zone, which this is a U.S. Carbine Association target. So real similar, it's almost exactly half scale. So it's kind of the equivalent of having 5 targets 10 yards away from us, but doing it on 1 target board. Save you some time on setup. But you get the same work. Moving the gun around from point A to point B, seeing what we need to see, firing that accurate shot, and not wasting any time. No dwell time is one of the things we're going to look at getting rid of here. Understanding that, you know, if we have a 50-yard zero on our rifle, you know, and the sight is, you know, in this EOTech, it's about two and a half to three inches, the line of sight above the line of bore. If we need to make all these shots land in this card, we'd have to hold ever. All right, that's adding some delay time in there, and we're not fighting a 3x5 card war right now. All right, these are visual references. So anywhere you see your dot or sights on this card, be okay with firing that shot. If you end up with shots below the card, we're cool with that, okay? If you end up with shots more than 2.5 inches below the card, we're not cool with that. That means the sight wasn't on the target when you shot. Same thing with stuff in between there. So sights land anywhere on number one. Boom, the gun fires. We see what we need to see. No more, no less. Let our eyes come out of the tube, okay? You're gonna have to bring your eyes out of this tube, move on to the next target. All right, you're going to start seeing the gun coming in, or the sight rather, breaking your vision. When that breaks your vision, it lets your eyes drift back through the tube, pick up the sight. It's going to save us a little time here. Little bits of time will start mattering, right? As soon as we see what we need to see on target number two, boom, the gun fires, eyes move on to the next target, gun fires, gun fires, gun fires. Okay, for single shots. We'll start nice and smooth through here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Never hurts to rehearse this a little bit, right? Nice and smooth through there, and then we'll pick up the speed. And as we start picking up speed, what we'll find out is there's a difference between how fast we can see and process and how fast we can see and process and output. That'll come into play when we start firing multiple rounds per target. We'll move from single rounds per target to 2 rounds per target and see how that shakes out for us. We'll start nice and smooth, pick up the pace, see where we start disconnecting from the gun and looking ahead to the next target before we fire the round that we need to fire on the target we're on. Sound good? All right, so let me grab these Peltors. Let's get some eye pro on, some ear pro on, and do it. So. All right, here we go. We'll start with some single shots in numerical order. Stand by. All right, nice and smooth through there. Maybe we'll pick up the pace, see if we can see and process and output a little bit faster. All right, okay, pick it up one more time. All right, groovy. Let's go ahead and top the gun off. Let's start working multiple rounds per target, okay? We start cruising through this thing. There's going to be that temptation for tactical shooters to double tap the target, all right, where we see the sights on the target. One time, press the trigger twice as fast as we can and hope that we win. Hope's not a course of action, okay? Let's let the gun tell us when it's time to shoot, and we'll save time on this particular exercise with vision speed and efficiency. See what you need to see, no more, no less. Let those eyes move on. And hey, for any kind of multiple target transition stuff, we're always going to lead the gun with our eyes. Whether it's tactical shooting or competitive shooting, we have to see it first. Tactical shooters have to make a decision first. So let's roll through this. 2 rounds per. All right, so that's nice and smooth. Let's pick the pace up a little bit. All right, pretty efficient on getting the work done there. We didn't waste a lot of time. That's what we got for now. Take it easy. We'll see you next time.
Trigger Time TV is brought to you by Crossbreed Holsters, Kel-Tec, Troy Industries, Troy Defense, Talon Ordnance, Eagle Shield, Nemo Arms, Fax and Firearms, Copus Mobile, Black Forge Weapons, Battle Rifle Company, Vertex, Wiley X, Dark Angel, and Meredith Rifles. Closed caption provided by Wiley X.